everybody. My name is Matt Elliott, and I'm here at the RV Corral in Eugene, Oregon on Highway 99. Today I want to show you a fantastic rig that rolled in here literally just minutes ago. This is a coach I'm very familiar with. I sold them for years. This is a Road Track, and the model that we're looking at is the 210 wide body popular. And this is a Chevy chassis, so then they're kind of hard to find, with the 6-liter engine. So it's got a lot of power. This is a nice V8 1-ton coach. It'll pull stuff really, really well, but it has all the mobility and all of the charming features that Class B vans bring to the table. So let's take a quick look around. When we look at a Road Track, for years, these guys were the innovators, the designers that had the biggest impact on this industry. And this coach is fantastic because, first of all, it's a little roomier inside. And you can notice that the body flares out a little bit. This is an all one-piece fiberglass superstructure, this hull. Most RVs don't have this kind of construction, and they hold up very, very well over time, which you could tell because we have a 10-year coach and the exterior is in beautiful shape. This is all automotive paint, two-tone. We've got alloy wheels on this coach. And one of the things that's kind of neat with this one is there's some interesting storage areas. Let's see if this is unlocked. See, there's room. This guy had all his blocks in here. Yeah, this, I'm not kidding, it just came in a few minutes ago, so we haven't detailed it or done any of that kind of stuff yet. When you look at the back, you can see, of course, here's the tow hitch. This spare tire carrier will fold down, and that gives you full access. But if you take a look in here, there is really a ton of storage. In fact, there's a extra drawer down below here on both sides. So you have a ton of storage in this back. Now this back thing is a sofa, and it's a sofa that will fold down and help complete a bedding area. When we look down this side here, of course, there's your water bay. This has an all internal water bay, so it's nice to use in colder weather. And then it's got this massive drawer that pulls out here. Let's see what's in here. Oh, it's got a chair in it. But this is a great big storage compartment. So that's one of the reasons why people might go to a wide body, so they get these exterior storage areas that a camper van typically doesn't have. We look in here, that's just a really nice Chevy in there. Got beautiful seat finishes and all the upholstery. It's fully loaded. And these drive great. You know, Chevys have a fully independent front suspension, and they really are a wonderful vehicle to drive. Of course, I'm a little biased because I've been selling these my whole life. Okay, let's take a look at the interior. Follow me. Okay, so now we're inside a Road Track 210 Popular. This is an interesting coach because one of Road Track's claims to fame has always been a low roof height. And so how they achieve the low roof height is that they have a drop floor in the center. So most coaches, when you walk in, you either have to have a taller roof or you have to be short. With this one here, I'm just a hair under 6 feet tall, and I can walk in and I've got plenty of headroom here. Now you can see that the front two seats swivel and make part of a living space. We also have a third seat here. This has storage underneath it. And then we have a lot of storage. This is a really nice galley, especially when you think about a camper van being such a small vehicle inside. We really have a variety of storage. There's lots of drawers. This one's got a cabinet in it with the silverware. And then look, watch this trick. So, got a built-in table. Everybody can use it. It's right here. When we come over here, got a beautiful little recessed stainless steel sink, and we've got a burner stove here, and then right over here, we've got a convection microwave oven. So we can bake and we can also microwave. All of your controls for the generator and all your monitor panel and your main fuse box and all this stuff is right up here, easy to get to, but away from the little button pushers. Nobody's gonna be touching that except for you. Okay, looking a little further at the galley, we've got a really nice size gas electric fridge, and this is actually a three-way fridge, so I can use propane for cooling. If I have a campground connection, I have 110, but it also has 12 volt, and that means that I can turn that on and leave it on even while I'm driving. So that's a pretty cool design. You don't see those really anymore. And there's more storage up here. And when you look at this rig, you're going to notice that all of the superstructures, all of the cabinets and everything they build in here is extremely high quality. They use hidden hinges. They are all either made out of plywood or solid lumber, and everything is screwed together. So what you don't get in a road track, even over the years, is a lot of leaks, squeaks, and rattles. You know, this coach, even though it's a 13, only has 33,000 miles on it, and it's beautiful. It's just, nothing's banged up in here. It looks really nice. Now, this has a special kind of bathroom design, and what happens with this, you can come around and see. Right here, we've got a toilet, a shower, and a sink all in one compartment. And when you're not using it, this is kind of cool, when you're not using it, it closes small, so I have more room in the hallway. When I'm inside there, it latches big, so the person inside has enough room, and the person out here can still get by. So that works really good. And then back here, we have a really interesting design. So for this, I've got a table set up here. I've got a jump seat here, and I've got a power sofa. Now, I can seat belt 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 people in this. Most camper vans don't have seating for that many people. And most RVs have a lot of unsafe arrangements where just you're kind of strapped in willy-nilly throughout the coach. But with this here, these are all forward-facing seat belts with shoulder harnesses, except for this middle one, which is a lap harness. And it's a nice safe rig to travel in with your kids and family members and friends. Okay, now what I want to do is make this into a bed. All I need to do is push a button and this couch lays down. I take this tabletop out and there's a piece that fills in the middle, and then we have a cushion that fits in here. So this whole thing can be set up as a bed. I used to travel in one just like this with a bunch of kids. And what we would do is everybody would ride back here when we were traveling, watch a movie or something, because there's a TV and a home theater system. And then we'd kick them out and my wife and I would sleep back here. Now, my wife's taller than I am, but we had plenty of room. So a really versatile design. Another unusual thing on this coach is that the air conditioner isn't up on top of the roof. So let's say that you have a clearance that you're trying to make that is under 9 feet. This coach will do it. But with the air conditioner up on the roof, it wouldn't. So now we have an internal air conditioner that vents out the back, does a great job of cooling this. It doesn't require a huge power supply, but this does have a generator on it, so it'll run everything in the coach. And like I said, not too tall, not too wide, very drivable. And this is an excellent example of one. As I said, it just came in. We haven't detailed this yet. It doesn't smell like cigarettes. It doesn't smell like somebody's cat. It hasn't been wet. It's really, really in nice shape. So that's a quick look at a 2013 Road Trek 210 Popular. Phenomenal coach, absolutely legendary product in our industry. And this one's only got 33,000 miles. I hope you enjoyed the video. I'd love to show it to you in person or answer any questions you have. So please feel free to give me a call. I'm Matt Elliott. You can reach me at 541-954-8495. You have a great day.